prints on my notes this morning, but as far as law we have it, around the bank. Okay, so, good morning, welcome to DriveCon. My name is Marcos Rodriguez. And to hear I'm here to talk to you about the Internet of Things, or IoT. So what is it? Some of you may have heard the term, so let me actually get a show of hands. Who's heard the term IoT? So we gotta ask ourselves, what is it really? When we say Internet of Things, what are the things in IoT? Let me take a quick show of hands again on another question. How many of you in the room have smartphones here today? Obvious question, right? Okay. So what if we dig a little deeper and I ask you, how many of you have smart bands or smart watch or some type of wearable that's connected? So some of us do. So we started to build this picture of what some of the things may be. So if we dig a little deeper, and we take this scenario of things that are connected to the internet, exchanging data, we go into the home scenario. So some of you may have heard of smart thermostats, such as Nest, which was purchased by Google a few years ago. This thermostat, for example, has the capability to know that you're in the room. It has the ability to detect and learn your home and away patterns, and thus has the ability to adjust the temperature in the room, saving energy and being efficient overall in savings cost. Some other examples that we see emerging in terms of things that are connected are smart appliances, for example. Some of you may already have some, such as Wi-Fi enabled washer and dryer, fridge, a weighted scale, all providing data into a cloud, into an application, and all being connected. So, let me take a moment and I encourage you to do the same with me here and imagine. And as you take a look around this room here itself, take a look at the table, the walls, the lights, even the chair you're sitting in. Now imagine these objects being able to communicate, providing data, exchanging data to your phone, about the environment, to your mobile application. Not only that, but these objects interact in different sites. So the walls could be taking humidity readings, different types of sensors, you, for example, the chair to detect who's sitting on it. And all this data can be exchanged to provide a more immersive environment in a physical location such as this. Other examples that we see today, such things as security cameras. Security cameras in your home, I'm sure a lot of us have these as well. These cameras have the capability of letting you know and sending you a message when something's at your front door. Another one that I'm actually thinking of buying myself for my home is an electronic security lock, where it's able to know who you are, and it's able to, for example, send you a message when your kids are home and the door has been locked or unlocked. Similarly, there are gadgets for your garage door. They can send you a message when the garage door has been opened, when it's closed, etc. So you start to get the picture of what these things are when we say the Internet of Things. The industry has a term for this, more technical aspect, and we call it end-to-end, machine-to-machine communication. For those who are sci-fi enthusiasts and fans, you may relate that as Skynet, but I don't think we're really there yet. So for myself, as another example, I have a smartwatch, I have a Garmin. It tells me a plethora of information. It tells me the weather, my heartbeat, which consequently is about 115. In fact, it's so smart, it knows that I'm on stage giving a presentation. It is a. So what does all this mean? So pretty. bunch of devices are connected, everything is communicating, everything's communicating to each other, communicating to your phone, applications, etc. Some numbers, because no presentation could be executed effectively without some numbers. I didn't get the slide up, so I'll just bring them out. It's estimated by 2020, which is only 2 years, there will be 20 plus billion devices connected to the internet. In terms of spending and revenue generation, there will be an estimated $3.4 trillion. This includes expenses in devices and services. So it's by no coincidence that most of the leading technical companies that we all know and love, such as Microsoft, Amazon, Cisco, Samsung, Intel, all have heavy investments into IoT. You can go to Azure IoT today and purchase services that are available today. They have dedicated infrastructures. Same with Amazon, Cisco, Samsung, and more. Let's take one example here of all these wonderful smart connected devices in a workplace scenario. Just a quick and easy scenario that may resonate more with us here, since we are security-minded folks and technical folks. So imagine you have now a bunch of devices that can talk, communicate, and exchange data. What would that do, for example, to identity and access management? What would that do, for example, to data and location and access controls? So, you know, today we have a RFID badge on the tap and gives us access. What if we change that into a smart band or a smart ID badge? But then it can be used to authenticate us as the employees into buildings, authenticate us into equipment or rental of equipment that is needed at an office, and also to provide authentication authorization for data access. So we start to think and see this picture about how these devices will change the way we do business, the way we interact, the way we collaborate, and the way we do things in our personal life. Your smart fridge, for example, can send you a reminder that your milk is slow once you've passed the supermarket, or to create you a grocery list while you're in the supermarket so you can go shopping and the list is automatically updated to your phone. So there will be, these devices will become in the future an integral part of multi-factor authentication. This enabling secure and seamless access to resources. As security professionals, we need to be really on top of these changing technologies. And we need to be able to adapt and change as products and features of these come into the market space. So why is all this really important? I kind of touched on it before, but it's really important because all these technologies in IoT, all the devices connecting, aware of each other, the physical environment, the virtual environment, is going to change and influence human behaviors, the way we do business, payment systems, etc., and the way we interact with one another. It's going to change the way society behaves, hopefully for the better, and certainly influence sustainability models for agriculture, etc. Another quick example. I was actually in Barcelona about 3 weeks ago, and I was surprised to find out that Barcelona in 2014 was awarded the European Capital of Innovation Award. Why? Because it's smart city innovations. So we're talking about IoT, devices that communicate, smart devices. So Barcelona is a smart city, and it is the benchmark that other cities are using. Three quick examples of what we've done with IoT to make it a smart city and how that translates into savings, better quality of life, and revenue. So all this came about in Barcelona after the 2008 recession or depression. They were hardly hit, so we needed ways to cut costs and generate some revenue. One of the first things they did is place parking sensors across every parking spot in the city. These parking spots are able to now signal or send their availability to anyone walking on the street or, well, not on the street, but you won't be walking, you'll be driving because you're looking for a parking spot. So our driver will get notification on availability map of all the parking spots in the city. What this translated to? It translated into a $50 million a year revenue increase from parking fees alone. Another example, cost savings example. We took all the street lights, we converted these to smart lamp posts, smart lights, LED lights. These lights have the capability of knowing where pedestrians are walking, knowing where and when the light is actually required, and turn themselves on and off as required instead of having the lights on all the time. This translates in the city of Barcelona to a savings of $37 million per year. And one last example. So Barcelona is a beautiful city. If you ever get the opportunity to go, please do that. It's very nice city. I was really impressed with my first time there. But a lot of things they have is gardens all over the city. So they were having an over expenditure of water in their irrigation system. It was an inadequate system. It has some controls, but not much. So they put sensors all across these gardens in strategic places. These sensors are now able to collect humidity, weather, soil samples, and thus now the irrigation system became a smart system, which they can now pour water when it's required at the right time, at the right place. This system alone is a savings of $50 million per year. So here a definition in text of IoT. I may have borrowed some pieces from the internet into this definition. So an ecosystem of inanimate objects with embedded sensors, software, and network connectivity enable these objects to send, receive, collect, and exchange data. So as security professionals, you can imagine what all this means. How do we protect all this? How do we manage it? How do we update it? How do we make sure this is secure? All that are questions. As an industry is still maturing, a lot of players not fully defined standards in the industry. And that's why now, at least I highlighted here, a very interesting point in my view. It is the convergence of the physical and digital worlds. So we talked about the chairs, the walls, those are inanimate objects. But now you can actually converge these into this digital world and exchange information or get information from these objects. To wrap that all up, it's everything connected. A connected world from the things you thought could never provide any information or valuable information. Now they can, and it's all rolled up into the cloud. And it's really unlimited potential for devising new products, the way you're using it, using the data and analytics. So in the spirit of, you know, the DriveCon, in the spirit of growth mindset, the only thing I will end off with is that the only thing that's really constant is change. And we must be prepared and ready